Welcome to the Heal Your Hunger Show, where we get to the heart of why you overeat and how to stop. If you struggle with food and weight like I did, welcome home. Welcome to the Heal Your Hunger Show. So happy to have you here. It is a great day to be alive. And hey, we're moving through COVID. How about that? We have a new normal and hopefully it will not last forever, but we're getting through it, aren't we? Yes, we are. You know, we're finding new ways of coping, new ways of socializing, new ways of getting support. And if you're feeling isolated, I implore you, please reach out for help and support. Don't go through this very strange, warped twilight zone of 2020 alone. You deserve to get support and don't ever feel like you're being a bother by reaching out for it. I am going to be talking today about what else, my own personal experience with something, and that's grief. But before I get into that, I just want to say welcome if you're here for the first time. The Heal Your Hunger Show is all about addressing issues that come up when we are, emotional eaters. Anything, you know, there's nothing off limits that I might talk about on this show. But it's typically not about food or weight loss. You know, I'm talking about the real stuff that has the byproduct of weight loss, that has a byproduct of overcoming emotional eating. But it's life stuff I'm talking about here, life and emotions and our experience of life, because that's the stuff that trips us up, right? Like, we can all follow a diet for a time, but why do we always go off the diet? Why do we always put that weight back on? It's because we haven't properly addressed the life stuff. Because after all, in my experience, it's a living problem, not an eating problem. Because let's face it, you know what to eat. Come on. You're not stupid. You've read enough books. You've been enough classes about nutrition. Like, you're pretty clued in about, you know, what's healthy and what's not. But does that mean you follow what you know? No. And that's the gap. And that's what we address here. Why don't we follow it? Well, it's usually because of emotional eating. So if you suspect you're an emotional eater, well, you probably are. But if you want to find out for sure, go to healyourhunger.com, heal, H-E-A-L, like the Heal Your Hunger Show. Go to healyourhunger.com and take the quiz. It's like a 3-minute quiz. And then you'll get your personalized score specific to where you are on the emotional eating spectrum. And you might even be a food addict because that's the high end of the spectrum. So take the free quiz and find out for sure. And also join us in the Secret Sauce group. That's where I'm recording this today. Go to Facebook and type in the Secret Sauce to End Emotional Eating and boom, we'll let you in. And that's where you can ask questions. You can comment on the show and just get support, you know, and really living an authentic life where you're following your heart, because that's so, so important to overcoming emotional eating, is getting in touch with who you are, getting the proper support, and then living as God intended you to live, which is full out with joy and love. So on with the show. So grief is a thing. And I want to talk to you about what I've been going through. Because, as you know, if you have tuned into my work at any time, I like to get real clear, real focused, and real authentic about the experience of emotional eating through the lens of my own personal experience. You know, there's nothing I hate more than when somebody's in their head and they're teaching, you know, from kind of an academic place. I don't relate to that. I feel like I can't connect. I'm a very emotional being, and I like to connect at the heart level. I find that to be most supportive. And so what I do in the work that I do is I start from square one, which is my personal experience. And that's really how my business is built, is on my own experience of overcoming emotional eating, because I was 50 pounds overweight. And basically, the process I went through to heal is the experience I draw on in my book, in my podcast, in the work that I do with my clients. But of course, you know, I've been helping women overcome emotional eating for over 30 years. So I definitely draw on the experiences of my clients and what they've been through as well. But, you know, if you've known one emotional eater, you've probably known us all. And that's what's so amazing about the Secret Sauce group. That's what's so amazing about my program and the Heal Your Hunger community, where my clients gather, you know, for group coaching calls and in a Facebook group, you know, together for those who are going through my program. You know, there's a commonality that we all experience that's so powerful. And when we are able to talk about our experiences and realize that other people have experienced the same thing, the same thoughts, the same feelings, the same sadnesses and joys and terrible negative thoughts towards ourselves, it's so useful to realize we're not alone. Because my experience is, as emotional eaters, we tend to think we're the only ones who feel the way we feel. We're the only ones who have done the things we've done. You know, I did a video once that I put on YouTube like 10 years ago about garbage eating. You know, I used to eat out of the garbage, not regularly, but I would binge on binge foods and then throw the food out. And, you know, and I'd be like, I'm never eating that stuff again. It's so gross. I'm never, you know, I never want to touch that food again. I ate so much of it. I was so stuffed of it. It was disgusting to me. But that was when I was full and had eaten a whole lot of it. But later, when I wasn't so full and I had room in my tummy, I started to get hungry and I'd start thinking about the food I'd thrown out and I'd go retrieve it. And I was like, Trisha, you are gross. Like, you're gross and you're like so base and I can't believe you've done this. Well, I reenacted that garbage eating scenario and put it on YouTube, and I got like over 60,000 hits. It was incredible. And all these comments of, oh my God, I've done that. So case in point, you know, our experiences as emotional eaters are so similar. And that's why I do draw on my personal experience, because I really want to touch the hearts of those who are in isolation and believing they're so bad because of their crazy eating habits and crazy thoughts around their bodies. So from that, I want to go ahead and share about another personal experience that I'm going through, and that is one of grief. You know, if you followed my work, I was married and now I'm getting divorced, and I was so happy to leave my relationship and finally get the courage to do that. Not that it was so terrible, but it was definitely not right for me, not the right fit for me. It hadn't been for a long time. We never just up and leave, right? We kind of suffer for a while and then leave, if, you know, that's what we're guided to do. So, you know, I was so happy to be free and to get out of that situation that I was just like, living life. I was just enjoying myself. I was enjoying the freedom to travel, to be with my family, to date eventually. And it was just very liberating and beautiful, because it was a 30 plus year relationship for me. I mean, literally a monogamous 30 year relationship. So you can imagine, I was wanting to experience new experiences. And so that was wonderful for a time, but as I came back to go through the divorce process with my husband, which we both had decided to postpone at first because we just weren't in a hurry. And then because of COVID, like even when it became time, I'm like, okay, let's do this. Then COVID hit and, you know, my husband was very isolated from COVID and had some anxiety. And I just felt like it's, you know, not the right timing. So we put it off. And then as COVID wore on, I thought, okay, gotta do this. Like, even though COVID's here, it's not going anywhere right now. And so let's go ahead and take care of this. And that's when the grief has started to emerge for me. So it's taken a while. And I just wanted to comment about this because it's really important that I go through this. It's really important that I feel these feelings, that I honor these feelings, because grief is a real thing. You know, it's a real process. It's been studied, you know, endlessly. There are real stages of grief that one experiences, whether it's the loss of you know, a family member or friend through death or sickness, or it's a loss of a pet, or a transition, you know, some kind of ending, and transition into a new chapter of your life. I mean, grief is a real thing, and I'm getting reacquainted with it. I think the last real grief I experienced was when my father passed, and that was 19 years ago, from cancer. And that was my first experience of realizing how real grief is and how it really is a thing. Like, and it's a force to be reckoned with, and you can't, you know, explain it away or treat it away or bury it away. None of those things. It's real, and you have to deal with it. Now, as emotional eaters, we tend to bury uncomfortable feelings with food, right? That's what drives us to eat. That's why we're always looking in the refrigerator. It's like, there's something going on inside of me. I don't want to feel it. Let me find a quick hit that will take care of these feelings. And we do that endlessly because the feelings keep coming back. So that's why we keep eating. That's our number one go-to. That has to be addressed if you want to lose weight and keep it off. If you want to be happy and healthy, you need new coping tools, obviously. But, you know, whatever you do to anesthetize your feelings of grief, you know, it's really, really important to realize that grief is real, and it is a process that in order to really be healthy, you have to honor and go through. You know, the shortest solution and the most effective solution is going straight through it. And as Winston Churchill once said, if you're going through hell, keep going. And that's, you know, something I'm coming upon right now. Not that I'm in hell, but I'm definitely having strong feelings of grief. And what does that feel like? Well, you know, when it was my father, you know, who had died, it was physical as well as emotional and spiritual. I had so much sadness when my dad died. And what I learned about grief was it is a real thing that happens on its own timetable. So I'd be standing in the checkout line at the grocery store, and I would be overcome with grief and sadness, and I would just start crying. And because I was well into my recovery from emotional eating, I knew not to stuff my feelings, not to push my feelings back, not to, you know, say, oh, I shouldn't be crying. I did not give a hoot. You know, when I was in the checkout line, if I started crying and I looked silly, I didn't care. You know, I just, it's, who cares? Really, really, who cares? I mean, people might have thought, what's wrong with that woman? But, you know, I was in my own process, and I didn't push it back. And not that I was sobbing and making a scene. Of course, I just had tears coming down my face, and I checked out, and then I went to my car and I continued to cry. So that's an example of it just coming when it comes. You know, it's like I'd see maybe a People magazine or something where I basically was reminded of my father in some way, or reminded of something that brought those feelings up. But grief is real, and it does come on its own timetable, and it's not convenient. You know, it doesn't come when we say we're ready for it, unfortunately. And that's the first time I really realized that I have to honor it and just be with it, flow with it, cry when I need to cry. You know, I also did things like write out my feelings, pray, get sleep, talk to friends. So these are all things that you know, helped me through it and are helping me now. So the grief I'm experiencing now comes from the fact that I'm ending a very, very long relationship. And what I'm experiencing now that sort of I've had my several, you know, months of fun and excitement and travel, and in spite of COVID, I've traveled some, and a new relationship, and all these things are wonderful. But when I've come home to go through this divorce process, it's brought the grief to the forefront where I cannot avoid it. You know, divorce is a not fun thing to begin with, right? It's just, it brings out the worst, I think, in both parties. Even though we've remained friends, we're committed to that. It's still, you know, fear will bring up our dark side, which is fear, you know? And so we don't always say things that we mean. We don't always act the way we're proud of. But basically, it's really, you know, it's a difficult thing that has made me feel bad. So the divorce part feels bad to me. And then the grief that the divorce is bringing up feels bad to me. And what I'm doing with that is being with it. You know, what I've learned from many years of trial and error is there's no problem that overeating will not make worse. Okay. So if you have a problem and then you deal with it by eating or don't deal with it by eating, now you have two problems. Like you have the problem to begin with, and then you have the fact that you feel disgusting and gross and stuffed and bloated, you know, and mad at yourself from eating. So the best thing you can do is not eat and go through the feelings. And again, that's hard for an emotional eater who's lived their lives, you know, stuffing feelings and deciding that, you know, we don't want to be uncomfortable at all costs. My experience is, in order to heal your hunger, you're going to have to feel your feelings. You're going to have to feel hunger and feel your feelings that come up when you're not stuffed. And so I'm sticking to my 3-meal magic plan, which does allow for some hunger and space between my meals. And when I'm not stuffed, when I'm not, you know, hating myself for my food choices, I'm experiencing feelings. And those feelings right now are heavy. They're heavy feelings of grief. And I'm letting them come. I'm just letting them come. I'm talking about them. I'm praying about them. I'm writing about them. I'm not dwelling on it. You know, I'm not in a morbid space, but I'm not my usual light, bubbly self either. I'm just not. And in fact, it's been hard for me to record podcasts because I'd like to be in that happy, bubbly space when I record. And I just sort of have this, you know, heavy, sort of depressed feeling. I just don't have the same sparkle that I normally do. And that's what I prefer, of course. And the reason I'm doing, this talk right now is because I want to show up warts and all. You know, I want you to know what I go through as an emotional eater and how I heal. So I heal by being real. Okay. If you've ever read The Velveteen Rabbit, The Velveteen Rabbit was a stuffed animal that became real, you know, by being loved, you know, was loved to a point of, you know, becoming real. But the beautiful thing about being real is you don't have to try to be anybody else. You don't have to put it on or put on a show. And so that's what I bring to you as my real self, you know, and hopefully my sparkle will come back in a little bit stronger way soon. But I think it's really important to talk about grief. And that's why I came on to talk about this here, is that heavy feelings, uncomfortable feelings, feelings of depression, these are realities for people depending on what they're going through. And I'm generally not a depressed person anymore. I used to be. In fact, depression used to chase me all the time. For years, depression chased me. And I found ways to combat that. And if you look back in my podcast, I do talk quite a lot about depression. I've had guests on to talk about it. But certainly, it's something that you can overcome through a lot of action, in my experience, a lot of self-care, and that worked for me. So for years, I have not been depressed, but feelings of grief feel like depression because it's kind of this heavy blanket. So what I'm doing is just going through it. I do the same thing day in, day out. I still meditate. I still pray. I still do my walk, pray. And I'm talking about it. And in fact, I just can't help but talk about it. I don't want to stuff these feelings. I don't want to bury it. I don't want to push it to the side and pretend it's not happening. I want to go straight through it. It's up for me. I did not feel it for a long time, you know, because I had so much going on and I was good with that. So long as it wasn't there, I didn't go looking for it, but it's here now. It's happening and I don't want to run from it. So I'm not eating over it. I'm not burying those feelings. I'm deep in self-care, and self-love. And what that means is that I'm acknowledging this, you know, I'm just like, hey, Trish, you're going through it. You know, you're going through it. It's time. You don't want to, you know, you don't want to sidestep this important phase of ending a relationship. And I know if I go through it, I'll be stronger and I'll be more available for my current relationships and for my old one with my ex. You know, we are committed to a friendship, and I want to be able to have that friendship without muddying the waters with undealt with grief or anger or anything else that I've had to work through. So that's really my message. It's short and sweet. You know, you got to go through it, whatever feelings you're having, but especially grief. And if you're wondering about the five stages of grief, they are denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance. And I do not feel necessarily like, the denial part, I mean, I might've denied the grief, but I didn't deny what I was going through or that the relationship was ending. I was very happy about that. I wasn't, you know, again, the stage of grief depend on what's going on. You know, if somebody dies, I think the denial and that shock, initial shock, is a normal experience that we have as a self-protective mechanism, emotional and psychological mechanism. And anger, obviously, these are our anger, bargaining, depression. These are natural stages that one goes through when they experience grief. And I think my husband, my ex, has gone through these stages for sure. I mean, I noticed all these stages in him. And he is moving through his own grief. For me, I'd say more of the depression, you know, and the acceptance is kind of where I am, because, as I said, I was very aware of what I was doing and I was grateful to be ending the relationship. So I wasn't in any kind of denial about it or anger about it. But I am having my own experience of grief, and that's what's most important, is that I'm doing it. I'm going through it. I want to get to the other side. The thing about grief and other emotions is we don't always get to decide when they end, right? We don't always get to decide, okay, we're done now. And I think that's one of the pitfalls of grief, is that when you go through it, you might be ready for it to end before it ends, or other people in your life might be ready for it to end before it ends. You know, they might be thinking to themselves, or maybe even saying, like, okay, I think you've done enough, you know, on this, and it's time to move on, you know. And that's tricky, because that can feel very invalidating. And you want to go through the feelings and make sure you deal with them and don't stuff them. And of course, you don't want to dwell on them and have them disable you either. So in my experience, the self-care is vital. You know, doing everything I can to get support is vital. And honoring the process and understanding and acknowledging that this is exactly what I'm going through. You know, grief is a thing. I'm in it. I'm not going to sidestep it. I'm going to feel the feelings. And I'm also going to keep living my life. So I get together with friends. I still laugh. The little, you know, moments of distraction from the grief feel great. But I don't want to live in distraction either. So it's a balance, right? It's a balance. So, but it's one day at a time, one foot in front of the other, moving through. And that's so, so important, is that we keep moving through with dignity and grace. So I hope that's helpful. I love you so much. I'm very grateful for your tuning in. And if those of you who are watching in the Secret Sauce group, please comment. That would mean the world to me. Comment about your own experiences of grief, or if you're going through grief right now, or if anything I've said has inspired you or made you think of something or realize something about your own process. But the most important thing is, don't bury it with food, because then you've got two problems: grief and feeling bad about your food choices and your body. And that does not help anything. That just compounds the problem. So be gentle with yourself, but find new ways of coping, because that's always going to be the best way, is to find new tools for coping and for getting through uncomfortable feelings, because that's all it really is, right? It's an uncomfortable experience that nobody wants to feel, but in order to heal, we've got to feel it. So thanks so much. I love you so much. Be well.
If you enjoyed this podcast and want to get free support, insider health info, exclusive invites to events, and more, visit healyourhunger.com.